Hey, ROGers. This is the unofficial No Frills somewhat tutorial video on the GPU-24 Charlie. I came across this last night while me and Amber were testing this mission out to see if we can get the hangars to be destroyed. And apparently, the GPU-24 has either been added or changed on December 2020. And this is how long since I've dropped them. When I put them on and armed them up, all of a sudden I had all the symbology that I didn't recognize. So after a little bit of time, I was able to go through it and figure things out. And so I tried to So first off, let's get this bird armed up with some of them. Options. Take 8. Take 1. So there's the GPU-24. Okay. 4. Okay, while they're loading that up, go ahead and get the rest of the ship taken care of. Now for now I'm going to leave it in HSI and I will show you why. Usual setup here. Headset on or helmet on. And see if we have a fear.
Rearming complete.
Okay, GPU-24 is up. Oh, I forgot the targeting pod. Options. Take 10. Take 1. Options. Take 10. Take 1.
5-6-3 tower. Make sure your anti-collision lights are on. 5-6-3 tower. Good.
Lightning might be helpful. Okay.
Copy.
So while we're waiting, I might as well go ahead and start the arming process of the GPU-24.
312.
And since we have weight on wheels, we can't really do much with it. I'll set the code.
Rearming complete.
Which one do we do? Because we have weight on wheels.
Roger.
Start it here. Take off, and we'll do it in the air. All right. Control washout. Salute.
Thank you, I'm gonna kill you when we get back.
To go ahead and bomb the crap out of his airbase's hangars because they won't blow up anyway. They're indestructible. So it's a good way to.
311, take angle 1.2 straight ahead, traffic 12 o'clock, okay, mile and a half to the Rhino, turn across. 177, lock on 5 and 4 miles, 880.
To get that burner, put the auto throttle on. Okay. Alright. Mr. Armand, air ground mode. Let's also get our FLIR to warm up.
Select the power back on. Power back on.
Now, the difference between the GPU-24 and the heavier, or the other GPU, which is 16, is the 24 has a penetrating warhead and has a different steering kit, which we can see. Fins on the tail don't have that protruding fin that they're both 2,000 pounders. Just a different head, different steering, different systems. Different menu options. So let me just level us off here. Yeah, about 18,000.
Power back on! Oh,
battle. Holding pattern. And we'll do that around 300 knots just to keep the speed going.
Hey, Summer, you're doing a nice job with the glide slope kind of working a little high on us. I need you to get your liner scored away out there at about 2 miles and you work it in and take that out of the equation. And then just listen to us.
Chatter off. Chatter off. There we go. Alright, a little bit quieter now. Okay, so we have mode, mechanical fuse, code, that's what we usually see. But we also have CLAR or CLAR, depending on who you talk to, and I quote Matt Wagner on that. Override. That's an override, which we'll get to later. So first off, let's set our code as normal. And standard default. Step through each one. Step. Okay, all GPUs have that recorded in it now. Okay, so first off, you will see there are different modes. There's CLAR PP, CLAR SL, and manual. Now CLAR, that is the PP, is for pre-planning, and SL is straight line. I forget what the C stands for, but LAR is launch acceptance region, same as our missiles, so it gives you a zone in which you can fire for optimal results. Let's start with straight line, because that's going to be the one that's most familiar. So with a straight line, if we select that, we need to set our fuse. Now, the seeker is in the nose, so we don't want a nose fuse, so we're going to set tail fuse. And we'll go to set, and let's get our FLIR up and running. We're timed out, so we can go ahead and turn the FLIR on. Select that, and pop open the hover. There we go. And now let's go find a target, because we won't be able to program anything else much in until we get a target, so break autopilot here. And we'll find Hammer's house. Well, it should be right at our 12 o'clock low right here. So let's set the FLIR. We're using the velocity. Whoops. Sorry about that. The wrong switch accidentally. Okay. Alright, we're setting velocity vector, so let's get the velocity vector on. It's about right over there. Turn to designate. Up, a little bit off. Target designate. Okay. And let's zoom in a bit. Just randomly choose this hangar. So I'm going to set a area track on it and designate it. Alright, back to our orbit. As you can see, we have a different set of symbology here. We have this dotted line that's native to the GB24, but it's the same bomb fall line as you're used to seeing. We also have a couple of bars here. There's a thick horizontal bar and a smaller horizontal bar here. This is our maximum and minimum range envelopes. So as you can see, there's a time to maximum range target timer. So that's the maximum range until we're in a position where we can drop the bomb on this target, which is 1.5 minutes away. As that starts to count down, we'll start to see a marker come down this line here, as you're used to seeing with regular drops. As soon as it crosses this upper horizontal line, that's the maximum range. This tag maximum range will disappear and it will say in zone, because now we're in the zone between maximum and minimum range to drop. At that point, just like your rudder drops, the marker will come down until it hits your velocity vector and the bomb will drop automatically, provided we're doing it in an automatic mode. Now we're choosing straight line as an automatic mode by default. If we wanted to do it other than automatic, we would use this button right here, CLR override, but we'll get to that later. For now, let's just have a look at dropping it in auto mode, and let's get that laser on. And we'll zoom the video out a little bit. Okay, here's that marker, this solid circle dot, 23 seconds to maximum range. And if you look down at our HSI, you'll see there's a zone box there. So have a look, the dot's coming in, it's crossing maximum range. Boom, now we're in zone. We're in zone in the HSI. And dot's hitting our velocity vector. So now the bomb is dropped. You couldn't see it because it happened kind of quick, but just like we normally drop, I just held the pickle button down. When that dot hit velocity vector, it dropped the bomb automatically. The laser is automatically lasing, hence LTD/R. Now if you notice though, it only says 94 laser and it's counting down. It's counting down how long the laser is going to be on. There is no time to impact timer that I have found, which I wish there was, so you know how much time you have to hold the target before you can leave, especially if you're being attacked. So anyway, boom, there we go, Shaq. Okay, let's head back out to sea and set up for the next bombing run. And as you can see, Hammer builds his hangars extra durable. Not even a scratch. Hammer contracts DCS as his construction crew. Okay. So we'll head back out to sea. Go ahead and cycle our laser here. Alright, we'll keep the same target. So again, designate that just in case so we don't lose it. This time we will again do CLR, but this time we will use the override. So we'll just get some range between us so we can make a run. Out a bit. Alright, we're about 10 miles from target, so I'll go ahead and turn slowly and lazily in. Now with the CLR override, it will not lock us into following the correct procedure for an automatic drop. So that is to say, for instance, when that marker dot comes down the bomb fall line, We could drop the bomb before it even gets into the zone. We can drop the bomb before it even gets onto our velocity vector, even though we're in zone. We can drop it any time we want to. The laser on. The laser will also be manually operated, so we will have to turn that on ourselves. Okay, so there's our zone. We're not in the zone, we have 35 seconds left, but watch what happens when I pickle. Bomb goes anyway. Also, the laser is not firing, although it's armed. We would have to manually choose the laser with the trigger. Now it's finally firing. See the blinking LTDR? I'm holding the trigger on the entire time. So, in short, CLR override gives you a lot of latitude as to how you want to prosecute the attack. But you have to do a lot of work yourself, and the chance of you hitting it if you drop your bomb out of parameters is pretty small. You do get, however, a time to impact indicator. Looks like about 2 more seconds. But as we expected, no impact. We launched it out of parameters. Okay. Let's head back out to sea and hope and pray that we didn't kill any innocent civilians in that. Gotta get some more range. Oh! One AI was destroyed. So we killed something. Let's see. Yeah, one ground target. Killed unknown. Okay. Well, hopefully it was a military target. Alright, this time, we'll go back to our automatic modes. Straight line again. Mechanical fuse is going to be tail as usual. That's already been set, actually. 1688 is on. Let's get our laser. Signal that puppy on. Okay, this time we're going to salvo them. I have 2 bombs left. As you can tell, because I'm poorly trimmed and I'm heavy on the right side here. So, to salvage them, we're going to choose. We have 2 left. We want to launch 2. So there's 2. Enter. And we want to salvage them. We want all of them to go at once, so multiple will be 2. And I'll leave the interval behind because I want them to basically fall on top of each other. Now, if you notice, with the salvo, and I do believe that it was different with the regular GPUs, but even though we have salvo set, here you can see quantity 2, multiple 2, only one of the stations is highlighted, which is very confusing. For a while it's like, why won't it select the other station as well? Well, it actually has. It just for some reason doesn't show in the symbology. So let's turn back and I'll show you that they all will drop as a salvo, even though the symbology shows that only a single station has been selected. So we have our symbology again for a straight line drop. Okay. Time maximum range is 1 minute and 4 seconds. Flare selected. CLRs. Straight line. We have a time and target. I'm not quite sure how helpful that is yet. Here's a maximum range or a minimum range. We're target designated. Attack track. So let's just wait for our marker. Our zone is coming up here. Our scale is set to 5, so it's off scale right now. But as you see, we're getting closer and closer to our zone for dropping. Now in SA mode, you don't get that. There have been times where you can get across instead. But other than that, everything's in your HSI. Okay. 10 seconds to maximum range. There's our marker coming down. Marker is coming through maximum range now, so now we're in zone. Everything lit up. Pickle down. marker's gonna hit our velocity vector, and boom. There's our salvo. And there is our laser, automatically lasing because we chose CLR without an override. Again, no time to impact counter, just a time for the laser to stay on, which is 94 seconds. So you can kind of guess that pretty much when you get overhead and the view rotates, that's about when the bombs will hit. And there we go. Okay, we are Winchester, so I'm gonna load up some more and show you the pre-plan mode. Bones out.